Welcome back. I'm Carl, and this is the second video in our hands-on AI series. In this video, we cover data cleaning, an extremely important practice for anyone wanting to build a machine learning application. This is a critical step when dealing with your own data. We have to make the images in a format that our models can understand. This means both scaling it to a usable size, as well as normalizing the data so that there aren't any extreme outliers. These outliers can break your network or cause exploding gradients. In machine learning, remember that images are not images as far as computer algorithms are concerned. They are simply multidimensional integer arrays. Consider data cleaning as a method of simplifying the data and reducing the noise and outliers. Now, let's take a look at a set of transformations that are commonly applied for cleaning up the data and their influence on images. All the code snippets can be found in the pre-processing Jupyter notebook. We will also be working through these in a later episode. The first transformation is called rescaling. Rescaling is an operation that moves your data from one numerical range to another by division using predefined constants. In other words, we are transforming the images from one size to the size we have predetermined to be the number of inputs for our machine learning model. Another type of transformation is grayscaling, which turns a color RGB image into images with only shades of gray representing colors. Grayscaling transformations throw away noisy pixels and make it easier to detect shapes in the picture. Depending on your application, grayscaling might be a useful pre-processing step. Next is sample-wise centering. The raw RGB data values in images range from 0 to 255. However, in order to get rid of vanishing or saturating values, we can normalize the dataset such that the mean value of each data sample would be equal to 0. This reduces the chances for outliers on each image and centers it on a normal distribution curve. In conjunction with sample-wise centering, you can use sample-wise standard normalization. This pre-processing step follows the same idea as sample-wise centering, but instead of setting the mean value to 0, it sets the standard deviation value to 1. So now instead of having these values be 0 to 255, they range from negative 1 to 1. This minimizes extreme outliers and gives us values that are ready to be digested by common machine learning functions. Featurewise is similar to sample-wise. A sample refers to an individual image, whereas a feature is a specific trait common on our whole dataset. Featurewise centering is performed on the entire dataset instead of on each individual image. In this case, the features are each of the R, G, and B values. To do this easily and to understand what it looks like, we compute the mean image from our dataset and subtract it from each image. While the mean image doesn't look great to us, it does show the most common features of our dataset. Since we already calculated the mean image of the dataset, we can also calculate the standard deviation for feature-wise standard normalization. This value is then divided from every image and pixel in our dataset. These transformations can help clean your dataset and reduce complexity to ensure you train an accurate model. Thanks for watching! Be sure to check out the links to read the article associated with this series and to learn more about AI. Also, stay tuned for the next episode where we learn to augment our dataset to increase the real-world accuracy of our model.
Hey, I hope you liked this video. If you haven't seen our other videos on the Intel Software YouTube channel, remember to subscribe, and don't forget to leave us a comment. Tell us what other material you'd like to see, and chat with other enthusiasts who watch our shows. See you next time.